I think with our national government that we must come to a program of gradual amortization of the national debt, or we'll never have any of it paid. But in closing, I want to say to my conservative friends here in this great state of Virginia that the conservatives of America must never give up. We must never get so discouraged by the socialism and the left-wing proposals that we throw in the towel. America is still worth saving. It's still the best place on earth. And while socialism has taken over too much in the country, there's too much that it hasn't taken over for us to ever give up the fight. And just a word about our foreign affairs of our country. Under our system, the president deals with foreign countries and determines our foreign policy. But I, for one, believe that our safety lies in strength and firmness, and that to equivocate or compromise can only lead to disaster. As early as August 1961, I made a speech on the Senate floor and urged a complete air and naval blockade of the island of Cuba. We could have let medicines and food go in, but we should have stopped the importation into that island, not only of implements of war and nuclear weapons and planes and bombers and tanks, but we should have stopped the importation of machines and equipment and cement and steel and aviation gasoline and lubricating oil and everything else.